I hope I'm live. It's got all these like instructions coming up at the same time. Okay. All right. If anybody is there, say hello. Oh, looks like there's no one there. So I'm going to take this opportunity to go live on Instagram at the same time. Just getting that set up. Hi, I am live on my screen on YouTube, but I thought I'd set up Instagram at the same time because I know a lot of you prefer Instagram. So if you want to send me a question, probably easier to head on over to YouTube because there it actually retains the questions versus Instagram. It'll flash it at me for 10 seconds, then it'll be gone. So that's why I'm trying YouTube for today. Hi, if you just joined, go ahead and say hello. Although I know sometimes people want to stay anonymous, so no worries either way. Okay, I'm going to start this live stream with the question that came in about, and I got it here for you to show you, MultiAbsorb. Somebody was like, how do I, they're still not clear on how to use MultiAbsorb and also how to use it in combination with Absorb Plus. So I want to, let's address that right away. So there's two versions, okay? This one is MultiAbsorb Immune Booster. It's like an elite version. It's scaled up with everything you might need during times of travel, stress, or if you're striving for peak performance in a sport, for example. That's MultiAbsorb Immune Booster. MultiAbsorb Daily Essential. This is your daily one. This is your normal daily, every nutrient you need, plus your amino acids. The way that you use these with Absorb Plus is it depends how much Absorb Plus you're taking. If you are currently on, I would say 4 to 5 shakes a day or more, you don't need MultiAbsorb because everything that you would get from here is already in the shakes. Except for the extra stuff that's in MultiAbsorb, like we've got stuff for eye health, cardiovascular, extra gut support, that's not in Absorb Plus because it's not elemental. It's actually moringa and spirulina. So it's got a tiny amount of carb in there. So if you're on an exclusively elemental diet, you're getting everything you need from Absorb Plus anyway. Wait till you're weaning off to switch on to MultiAbsorb Immune. So if you are on 4 shakes a day or less, which then you're not on probably on an exclusively elemental diet because you can't get enough calories on 4 shakes a day or less, unless you're trying to lose weight, then yeah, you take a scoop of Daily Essential or Immune. Now, okay, so Daily Essential is completely pre-digested. It is elemental. Immune Booster is not 100% elemental. It has some herbs in there that have the carbohydrate component, okay? So just keep that in mind because maybe you are completely elemental at 4 shakes a day because you're trying to lose weight. Then don't put Immune Booster in your shakes. Put Daily Essential in your shakes. This camera, I'm so spatially challenged. But anyway, sorry, Instagram, these are the products I'm talking about. So if you're on 4 shakes or less, then go ahead and throw either of these into your Absorb Plus shake. If you've tasted these, the orange mango, which is what I have here, the orange mango MultiAbsorb, these cameras are not very good on these live streams, but anyway, this one tastes incredible. It's delicious. Why is a telephone call allowed to interrupt an Instagram live stream? I don't know. That's what just happened. I can't control that. Anyway, the orange mango MultiAbsorb is freaking delicious. So I like this as I have this with my lunch as a juice. That's the time of day I like to take it. So you want to take either of these. You want to do morning or afternoon. Don't do it at evening because it'll give you so much energy. You might have trouble sleeping. So that's the other thing with these two. And again, your secret for MultiAbsorb Daily Essential is put it in your water, stir it, leave it for 5 minutes, stir it again, it's absorbed. It's complete. You don't have to sit there squashing lumps or whatever. Just wait 5 minutes or 3 minutes. For multi-absorb immune booster, because of the spirulina, the moringa, the chlorella, this has a stronger taste. So I don't like this just mixed in water. Some people do. I don't. So this one, I'm throwing in an Absorb Plus or a protein shake or a smoothie. That's this one. So that's how you use these two. Now for me, if it's winter or I'm traveling, I'm using immune booster. If it's daily, during the summer, I mean, I eat really well. I eat homegrown composted soil. So I don't need this every day in the summer. I take it unless I'm working really hard. If I'm doing like 5 to 6 hours of physical labor a day, I'll still take this. But otherwise, this is my go-to for, you know, summer, spring, fall. So I hope that answers your questions. If you've got any more questions about multi-absorb, just hit it in the comments on either YouTube or Instagram, and hopefully I'll see it. Okay, next question. In my country, the brand Natren is really hard to get. Do you recommend any other brands? Unfortunately, no. It's really terrible that in 25 years, there is not another probiotic manufacturer that matches Natren in terms of culturing, extraction, refrigeration, refrigerated shipping to keep it live. Like Natren is a live bacterial product like yogurt or kefir. So I think if you can't get it in your country, and I know the shipping, we ship worldwide, but the shipping is substantial on a refrigerated product. Your best option is to culture your own yogurt or kefir. And in that case, it's really important the starter culture that you use. So, you know, get in with whatever community in your country is involved with traditional foods, right? That may be a New Age group. It may be a homesteading group. It may be a prepper group. Like whoever is involved with, who understands that food is the foundation of health, get involved with a group like that and see and ask about their starter culture, right? For their kefir or their yogurt. So there's a guy down the road from me here that I buy raw milk from. And I also buy kefir from him because he has a starter culture from a friend who came from Russia. Now, Russia understands traditional fermented foods. They understand how to do it safely. They've never stopped doing it. And they have, you know, a high track record in producing potent brands. So does somewhere like Bulgaria, possibly the Ukraine. You know, you kind of be as picky about your yogurt and kefir strain as you are about your packaged probiotics, is what I'm saying. Okay, next question. Suffering with Crohn's, currently symptom-free, only severe acne still there. What should be done? Okay. Now, I've never done this before. I can share my screen on YouTube. So I'm going to go ahead and try to do that because this is something I want you guys to know beyond a shadow of a doubt. I want you to know how to find anything that you need without having to wait for me to do a live stream, without, you know, having to email in. And so I'm going to show you, and now let's see if I can share my screen. It says I can. Select. Okay, I'm just going to go entire screen. So you're going to see, let me pull this out bigger so you don't have to see a bunch of other confusing stuff behind. Okay, allow. Okay, so now you're seeing my whole screen and I'm going to switch to here. Okay, so for those of you on Instagram, I've gone to listentoyourgut.com. I'm here on the home remedies page. There's a drop-down menu here that's always sitting in the top browser. There's also a drop-down menu on the main page. And look what we have here. Acne or pimples. Click on it. Boom. Here's your treatment protocol. This is, again, stuff that we know works. It's tried and tested. All your instructions are here. Number one, probiotics. Number two, detox. Number three, clear infected pores. You get a free download for my ebook, What You Need to Know About Wild Oregano Oil, which is one of the substances that you're using. And then here's your bullet point instructions. Do this, do that, repeat. And a treatment summary for those of you who have trouble with reading comprehension, just pop down here and it'll speed it up. So I've really tried to make these symptom pages as easy as possible for you guys. All right. Okay. I hope that worked. I sure hope that worked. Okay. So back to the questions. So for your question, go to my home remedies page, drop down menu, click on acne. All your instructions are there. All right. Can you use Comfrey salve for a fistula? So Comfrey salve is an incredible, amazing wound healer. All right. And aside, I've produced a wildcrafted batch from my own ranch here that I'm going to be making. I have a very limited supply because it was my first time creating salve. So I didn't want to do too much in case, because I was, of course, me, I'm always innovating. I was like, I don't want to just use olive oil. I want to use kokum butter in there and I want to use some essential oils. So I did a smaller batch. I think it's absolutely fantastic, but I have reserved from some for you guys. I can't sell it through my shop because it doesn't have, you know, all of the legal Health Canada NPN numbers and blah, blah, blah. And if I ship it to the States, you're not going to be able to afford to buy it. So I'm going to sell it. I'm going to set up an Etsy store and I'm going to sell it to you. I'll send you guys out an email. So if you're on my email list, and I'll put a video up here on YouTube and Instagram letting you guys know, again, I'll have a limited supply, but I am going to make that available. I'm also going to make, I also made my own burdock root, which is a fantastic cleanser and detox agent. And if you got the jibby jab, burdock is going to help get a lot of those constituents out of your system. So just an aside. Anyway, that's coming. So can you use Comfrey salve for fistula? No, because a fistula is infected. And what a fistula is a drainage hole that the body has created to stop, to give the infection, the pus and all the garbage that your body is using to heal and repair that wound, it has to get it out the body, right? And the problem with a lot of the drugs for Crohn's and colitis is they cause fistulas because they drive the infection deeper into the tissue so that, oh, we biopsied your surface, it all looks good. Yeah, because you drove it all deeper down into the tissues of the mucosal lining. So anyway, just my little side rant there. But no, so you do not use Comfrey until your fistula is healing itself, which shows you the infection is done, right? So again, if you go to my blog or my home remedies page, you click on fistula. I have anal fistula and I have rectovaginal fistula instructions. Okay, someone, sorry, I'm so easily distracted. Someone said also taking oregano oil directly on the tooth, like you said. Yes, so good. All my son's teeth as a child rotted out his head. He had no pain. We just put full strength wild oregano right on there. His adult teeth came in perfectly straight, perfectly healthy. So just an aside on that. Anyway, so with the fistula, you want to use the fistula healing protocol to heal the infection first. Do not use Comfrey anywhere there's active infection because Comfrey heals so fast. It'll like start healing over, but your body's like, where's my drainage hole? I have to get these other constituents that are part of the healing process, but not needed and byproducts. I need to get them out of the body. Don't seal them in. Okay. All right. Children and IBD. What do I do if my child can't drink the shakes? They make him gag. And it looks like he can't drink shakes or smoothies. I'm a mom of three. And I had that son with the dental issues, extreme gag reflex, which is why we couldn't take him to the dentist. So now, if I'd known about tapping, right, like EFT or my program, laser tapping, I would 100% have taken him for a tapping session about the gagging. That is something that is ideally addressed with laser tapping or EFT tapping, either one. If you like my program, go to lasertapping.com. I integrate it more with the body because I'm a certified EFT practitioner, but using it over the last two decades, I noticed that I use it in a different way and I really integrate it with the physical cells and tissues. So that's what laser tapping is. So lasertapping.com. That would be the only thing that you could do to get that gag response down, or hypnotherapy might work too. Hypnotherapy would be the other one that I would try. Otherwise, you know, I mean, I'm not going to assume. So give him a straw, tell him to suck it to the back of his mouth and swallow through the straw. Don't squish it around his mouth. If they're open to it, have them hold their nose while they're drinking it through a straw, because that can break that association. That's about all. Or maybe he wants to drink it with a spoon, like soup. Maybe that triggers a different association in their brain. So there's a few things for you to try. Let us know if you have success with that. Okay, I was diagnosed with ulcerative colitis in my teens, managed it pretty well until 4 years ago when I flared severely. A hospital stay and two blood transfusions and the last few years of holistic work and emotional freedom work. Yay, love it. You're doing the mind body. Awesome. I am on the mend. But one major side effect I've noticed is heart palpitations, extreme fatigue, and low stamina. I was going to say, get your hemoglobin checked. But here she says, I take Angstrom iron and magnesium once or twice a day, but wondered if you have other suggestions to help strengthen heart stuff. So with those conditions, I would guess you have fairly severe anemia. If you don't know, please go and get your blood work tested for both your hemoglobin and your stores, your ferritin stored iron. And that'll give you an idea of what kind of deficiency you're dealing with. Now, here's your thing. Do I have it here? No, I have the magnesium here. I keep this on my desk because I use it so much. So if you're using the Angstrom iron, which also comes in this form, or we do sell a larger one from another seller, you have to take, with any iron, you have to take folic acid, you have to take vitamin C, and you also have to make sure you're getting B12 and ideally the other B vitamins. Okay. So if you've got either one of your multi-absorbs, you've got everything in there, except for you might want to do a little more vitamin C. Again, I've kept things like vitamin C and magnesium low in here because they trigger bowel movements for susceptible people. So these products are really tailored for people with sensitive guts. Otherwise, you have to take a supplement. And for your folate, make sure you get a methylated version of folate. Don't take folic acid. It's not good for your body. It doesn't help. So you have to take those cofactors along with your iron. All right. And again, for detailed instructions on that, exactly what I showed you guys before, here we're going to do it again. We're going to share a screen. We are going to share a screen. And okay. It has all the instructions there. So hope that helps. Now, let's just say that you have all those symptoms and I'm assuming you have low iron or you wouldn't be taking the Angstrom iron. So that literally is all it can be. Just get, and you know, the heart is a muscle, so you're taking the magnesium. So that's great. I would think you just need more. Now, if that's too difficult for you to combine the supplements and you want the easy, I don't have it here, but I carry it in my shops. It's Ferrosorb by Thorn Research. Best iron supplement you can get on the market that's in like a capsule form where you just swallow it. But for me, because I have an old scarring in my throat, I don't swallow any capsules. I just drop my Thorn Research into water, mix it up, drink it. It has virtually no taste. That is a super easy way because the Thorn Research Ferrosorb already has the vitamin C, the folate, and the B12 in there to maximize your absorption uptake of your iron. Another little known thing, eggs for some reason interfere with the absorption of iron, so don't take it at breakfast if you're having eggs. Okay. So my daughter is starting on Stelara for ulcerative colitis, is starting on Listen to Your Gut recommended supplements. Okay. I do not give medical or pharmaceutical advice. Obviously, that is a question for your doctor. Not going to touch that one. Not going there. Do your own research. Consult your physician. Follow your gut. What do you think about ozone therapy? Okay, but I will say in response to that last question, I can tell you what other people have done. And a lot of other people have started on holistic treatment, natural herbal therapies while on their drug. And they've, as they gain fluency with the natural methods and they start, it's hard to see results because the drugs are often working against the natural supplementation, but at least for them to build fluency, build tolerance, and then they gradually. Best if you get, you know what, if you get an integrative physician or a functional medicine doctor, they are knowledgeable about the natural substances and they can support you with managing or weaning off the drug usage. So I would go that route, you know, get some consultation, get some help. Next question. What do you think about ozone therapy? I have done a hyperbaric oxygen chamber. It made me extremely dizzy. I did not like it at all from a claustrophobia perspective. Like you just like sealed in this thing. It's not an enjoyable experience for me. I didn't notice any positive effects that would have justified the experience for me. I've used ozone in the rectum. I've used it in a number of ways. Philosophically, I think it's good, but I personally have not seen great results from it. So use it as an adjunct, but it doesn't touch the therapies that I have in my books or on the home remedies page on my site. Question just came in. Are eggs okay to consume while on the healing phase if we have no issues on it? Yes, 100%. I love eggs, especially egg yolks. And if you have issues with eggs, try the yolks because that's where all the nutrients are. The anti-nutrients are in the whites, which are neutralized by substances in the yolks, but the yolks are very easy to take. You can add them into soup. You can add them into pasta. You can do like toast soldiers and dip your gluten-free toast in the egg yolk. How do you solve a recurring fistula? It keeps coming back. The best thing for you is to go to my blog, type in abscess and type in fistula. And there's a whole bunch of posts that come up. Read the comments on those posts, right? And these are people who have used my advanced formulas. I don't know if you've seen my advanced formulas that include DMSO. And they also use infrared lasers. So there's a ton of information in the comments section. There's like a mini book in there. So take the time to go through that on my blog. All right. ListenToYourGut.com. Click on the blog. All right. I think we are at the end of the questions. And thank you for joining me today. I hope all the tech worked out. We're going to find out at the end. But it looks like everything went fine, Instagram and YouTube. So thank you so much. Someone just here, who can help us get my daughter off Humira? Again, any functional medicine doctor. There is a woman in the UK called Nishta Patel, who's very experienced. She's on my list of recommended practitioners. There's Dane Johnson in the United States, super experienced, gotten tons of people off their drugs. He's not cheap, but he's worth every penny. If you don't know where my recommended practitioner page is, email us at service@listentoyourgut.com and we will send you that link out. So yeah, that should be easy to do. But yeah, you need a physician's guidance on that. I would definitely recommend. Okay, we're done. There's no more questions on either. Thank you for joining me and wishing you guys an awesome weekend.